Let's start, guys. First of all, we'll discuss a little bit about the basics of ECG. The standard speed or the paper output speed is the rate at which the ECG machine produces a trace. The standard output speed of the paper is 25 millimeter per second. So according to this speed at 25 millimeter per second, we know that one small square is equal to 0.04 second or 40 millisecond, and one large square is equal to 5 mm or 0.2 second. So 1 second, there will be how many large boxes or large square in 1 second? 25 mm per second means 5 large square in 1 second. So because of the speed or the standard speed of the ECG paper, the one small square is equal to 0.04 second or 40 millisecond, and one large square, which is equal to 5 mm, is equal to 0.2 second. And 250 small squares, there is usually a rhythm strip at the bottom of the ECG, which is usually lead number 2. And rhythm strip usually contain 250 small squares or 50 large squares. So in 1 second, we have 5 large squares. And in 10 seconds, how many large squares will we have? In 10 seconds, we'll have 50 large squares or 250 small squares. Hope you people are following me. So the first thing to do when you see an ECG of the patient is to calculate the in a big square. In one big square, there are 5 small squares. In one big square, there are 5 small squares. Look at this diagram. Can you see these bold lines? This one, and this one. Can you see these lines? Yes, this is a large square. The total number of small squares in a large square is 25. 1, 2, 3, if we count all the small squares. But if we only count the horizontal small squares, such as this one, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Whenever we are referring to the time scale on ECG, we only calculate the small boxes or small squares which are present on the horizontal line. So one large box contain 25 small squares, और वन लार्ज ब्लॉक इज इक्वल टू वन टू थ्री फोर फाइव स्मॉल स्क्वेयर्स ऑन द हॉरिजेंटल एक्सिस। सो यस डॉक्टर मुशरत, यू आर राइट, देर आर 25 स्मॉल स्क्वेयर्स इफ वी काउंट ऑल द स्मॉल स्क्वेयर्स इन अ लार्ज स्क्वेयर। बट वेन वी आर रेफरिंग टू द टाइम सच एज मिली सेकेंड्स और सेकेंड्स, देन वी विल ओनली काउंट द फाइव स्मॉल स्क्वेयर्स फ्रॉम दिस लाइन टू दिस लाइन, वन टू थ्री फोर फाइव। आई होप यू गॉट दिस पॉइंट। So one large square is equal to 5 mm and it contains five small boxes. So one small box is 1 mm. Now how to calculate the heart rate from ECG? You already know the formula. I'll repeat it. There are three methods to calculate heart rate from ECG. One method is we calculate the number of small squares between RR interval, between two R waves. We calculate the number of small squares and divide it on 1500. Or we calculate the large squares between two R waves and divide it on 1300 if the rhythm is regular. If the rhythm is regular, then we can apply one of these methods to calculate the heart rate. But if the rhythm is irregular, then what you need to do, if the RR interval is irregular, you need to calculate the number of R waves in a 10 second period. We need to calculate the number of R waves in a 10 second period from the rhythm lead. And the rhythm lead is usually 10 seconds long. And how many large squares are present in the 10 second period? 1 second is equal to 5 large squares. So 10 seconds will be equal to 50 large squares. So we will calculate the number of R waves in a 10 second strip or in a 50 large squares. We will calculate the number of R waves and divide or multiply it by 6. So it will give us a heart rate if the rhythm is irregular. Let's do some examples. Now look at this ECG and tell me the heart rate. How to calculate the heart rate? We need to calculate the number of large squares between two R waves. So one R wave is this one, one R wave is this one. How many large squares are present between these two R waves? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Almost 5 large squares. So 300 divided by 5, it's almost 60. Yes, 5 large squares. Can you count the small squares? How many small squares between two RR or two consecutive R waves? Five, five, 26, almost 27. You do not need to calculate the total small squares. You just need to calculate the small squares along the horizontal line only. Because the vertical squares are for voltage. So the number of small squares are 5, 10, 15, 20, 25, 26, and 27. So the number of small waves or small squares between two consecutive hour waves is 27. So 1500 divided by 27. So if you are calculating, when should you use both of these methods? If the heart rate is very much increased, such as in supraventricular tachycardia or just tachycardia, we can calculate the small squares and calculate the heart rate. And if there isn't any tachycardia, the heart rate is normal, then we calculate from the formula of large squares. Calculate the last squares between 2 hour interval and divide it on 300. Now, what if the rhythm is irregular, the hour interval is irregular, then we will calculate the number of hour waves in a 10 second strip. What is a 10 second strip? How many large squares are present in a 10 second strip? Can any one of you tell me? How many large squares are present in a 10 second strip? Anyone? One second is equal to 25 millimeters. 10 second will be equal to how many millimeters? Because the paper speed of, yes, 250 mm will be equal to 10 second. How many large boxes in 250 mm? How many large squares in 250 mm? We need to know the large squares because we cannot calculate, yes, 50 large squares. So 50 large squares is equal to 10 seconds. 50 large squares is equal to a 10 second strip. So if the rhythm is irregular, such as in atrial fibrillation, then we'll use the 10 second strip method. Then you will use the 10 second rhythm strip or 10 second strip method. What we do in that method, we calculate the number of R waves in 50 large squares. So the lead shown at the top of the diagram, which is this one. Tell me how many large boxes this strip contain.
Count the large boxes in this strip and tell me how many large squares.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Let us calculate it together. 3, 4, 5, 1, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28, 29, 30, 31, 32, 33, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10.
50 large squares. Remember that the rhythm strip. I ask you to calculate it just to make you understand. But remember that the rhythm strip is always 10 seconds long. The rhythm strip given at the bottom of the ECG, which is usually lead number 2, is 10 seconds long and it contains 50 large squares, as in this diagram. If you calculate again carefully, then you will see that there are 50 large squares. So if the rhythm is irregular, we will calculate the number of waves in a 10 second strip. Now, how many R waves are present in this strip? Nine R waves are present. Nine R waves mean 9 beats. Nine R waves mean 9 beats per 10 second. But we have to calculate the heart rate for 1 minute. So because these R waves, which are 9, is for 10 second, we will multiply it with 6. So if we multiply it with 6, then the answer would be 54. I hope both of you got this point. How to calculate a rhythm is irregular. The method is very simple. We count the number of R waves in a 10 second rhythm strip and multiply it by 6. Then we'll get our heart rate. Is it clear or you want to ask any question? No questions? If the rhythm is regular, then you either calculate the large boxes or calculate the small boxes. In regular one, we divide the number of big boxes between 2 R waves by 300. Or number of small boxes between 2 R intervals sometime the patient will have tachycardia, and tachycardia will have 1.5 large box. So if the large boxes are not complete, such as if there are 1.5 large box between 2 R waves, then it would be difficult for you to calculate the heart rate. In that case, you can use the small square method. But if the heart rate is very slow, the person is having bradycardia, then you can use the large square method. So Dr. Musharat, to calculate the heart rate, if the RR interval is regular, first you need to calculate the number of last squares between two R waves. Let's calculate the number of last squares between these two R waves. The number of last squares is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So there are 5 last squares between these two. We divide this 5 by 300. 300 divided by 5, which is almost 60. Now, what is the small square method? In small squares, we calculate the number of small squares on the horizontal line only, not the total small squares. I think you are getting confused because you calculate all the small boxes which are present in a large box. Just calculate the number of small boxes on the horizontal line. So calculate the number of small boxes between two R waves and divide it on 1500. 1500 divided by number of small squares. Okay, Dr. Musharak, this is a little zoomed diagram. Calculate the number of small squares with me. Now count these small squares which are present between this R wave and this R wave. Let's count 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27. So the number of small boxes between this and this R wave is 27 small squares. We'll divide it on 1500 by 7, which is almost 55.6. Is it clear now, Dr. Musharat? There is still confusion, you can ask. So we now know how to calculate the heart rate from ECG. The second step to do is to see the rhythm. How we see the rhythm on an ECG? We see that if the RR intervals are regular, if the distance or the number of small boxes between all the RR interval is same, then it means the rhythm is regular. If the RR interval is not regular, then we'll say that the rhythm is irregular. We calculate both the heart rate and the rhythm from the rhythm shift, which is given at the bottom of the ECG as lead number 2, 10 second long ECG strip. So the third thing that we see in an ECG after rate, rhythm, the third thing is axis. What is axis of the heart? what is cardiac axis? Cardiac axis is basically a representation of visual representation of the current that is flowing in the heart muscles. So we know that the current usually start here in the SA node, and then it travel downward and towards the left. It depolarizes the atrial muscles, then it depolarizes the AV node, and then it depolarizes the left ventricle and then right ventricle. So this is how the current flows in the heart. If we add all the vectors of the cardiac, all the axes of the cardiac current, then the overall or the added vector is directed downward and towards left, which is this one, almost 60 degree or 59 degrees, the normal cardiac axis. So normally the cardiac axis is directed downward and towards the left. Downward and towards the left. Now what happens in axis deviation? If the direction of the depolarization of the heart muscle changes, then the cardiac axis is also changes, the cardiac axis also changes with respect to that direction of the depolarization, or it deviates towards that site to which the maximum current is flowing. We normally calculate the cardiac axis by seeing the QRS complex in lead 1 and lead AVF. In lead 1 and lead AVF, we can calculate the cardiac axis. Normally, the normal cardiac axis is between lead AVF and lead 1. Normal cardiac axis is between plus 90 degree and minus 30 degree. So if the cardiac axis is here, then it's normal, it's here, it's normal, it's here, it's normal. If it's less than minus 30 degree, means if it come here, if the cardiac axis is here, then it's called left axis deviation. And if it's more than 90 degree, such as plus 120, 140, 180, then we call it as right axis deviation. And if it is extremely deviated towards the right one, such as it crosses the 180 degree and comes here, then we call it as extreme axis deviation. So from this diagram, did you understand that what is the normal axis of the heart, what is left axis deviation, and what is right axis deviation? The normal axis of the heart is between plus 90 and minus 30, directed downward and towards the left. And if it's deviated further to the left beyond minus 30 degree centigrade, then it's left axis deviation, because this one is the left side of the heart. And this is the right side of the heart. So if it's deviated beyond plus 90, then we call it as right axis deviation. And if it's between 180 and minus 90, then we call it as extreme axis deviation. Did you get this point? So normally the depolarization wave or the Krant wave starts from, because the heart is directed like this towards the left. So normally the current that starts in the AV node goes downward and towards the left. So the vector of the heart is downward and towards the left, like this. The collective vector of the heart current is downward and towards the left. This is downward from here to here. This is downward and towards the left, and the normal cardiac axis, because the direction of depolarizing current is downward and towards the left. So normally the cardiac vector is downward and towards the left, because why? Because the direction of the depolarizing current is downward and towards the left. Because the normal anatomic position of heart is towards the left. So the direction of the depolarizing current is also towards the left. This is normal cardiac axis. The normal cardiac axis is normally between plus 90 degree and minus 30 degree. Here heart is lying and it's